I've always been really passionate about human vision and what it is to see the world and how it feels really complex, but actually the brain sort of pieces together so much to make our sense of sight that technology like augmented reality can really play a huge role in people who don't have much in the way of light sensing ability. Once you start to lose your sight, it really becomes difficult to differentiate between, say, a foreground object and a background one. They kind of blur together. We're making use of the sight that people still have, and it may just be the detection of light and movement or a small amount of shape detection. And so what we do is put that on the inside of a pair of glasses. This device is a large battery controller and processor, but the key thing is you've got these really simple controls, but the modes that we set were really what we're trying to investigate. So this is the simplest of all, so it just shows a depth map with a person or an object nearby is very, very bright. Then we can start to increase some of the details here by taking up one mode. So now the person now has a little bit of brighter outlines and there's a person revealed and some chairs behind in the background. We also looked at some stuff where we'd also apply some cartoonization for anything that was near enough in front. So now we have one face here. It's quite pixelated, but you know, it can give you a gist of there's a person there. And then there's another one where we just look at pure contrast. So this gives you a whole bright display and sort of boosts the contrast of objects. You can zoom in, magnify the image, you can pause it if you want. Because some people need to have that kind of ability to kind of pause an image and investigate a bit further. So it's really a huge range of stuff because blindness is such a diverse condition. It's really trying to suit the actual person's needs. Most of the people we work with have had full sight at some stage in their life and it's degraded over time. So they know what objects look like and they, you know, I guess they miss them and things like that. But with faces, I think that's the really profound thing. Is you, a lot of people have said that they're bound to see their daughter's faces and interact with them over the table. And you know, not really ever thinking they would be able to have that experience again. And so that sort of stuff feeds back to the lab and you know, it's all you know, remarkable. We all get so excited about that. Some of the other stuff is about being able to naturally see obstacles. So obviously you know about people use a cane or a guide dog often to walk around objects. That gives you immediate localization of obstacles, but doesn't give you a bigger sense of awareness. So some people will often walk into cars or billboards or things like that on the road. And our glasses give you a real heads up about that. A lot of people comment about this sort of freedom of movement and their ability to go out with more confidence and go to dark places like bars and restaurants where sight would be limited.
At the heart of it, this is a medical device. This isn't something that someone's going to roll up to the store and buy off the shelf. How does the fact that you're making this product that is inherently an aide of some kind, how does that impact your business?
So it's not a traditional startup where you've got a gigantic market and you know a relatively well-defined one that you can just ask an investor, here we go. No one's ever tried to sell devices like this. It's essentially like a hearing aid for vision. You know, it's really unknown. So raising money was about finding the right type of investor who was prepared to carry a bit of that risk, but also have a potentially philanthropic interest in this work as well. And so we did find an investor who covers all those aspects. In the future, a lot of us will be using smart glasses. You know, I think that's naturally, well, that's what we all think is going to happen, you know, quite soon. So I like the idea of exploring this definite need and building up our platform of technology so that, you know, maybe in 5 years' time when, you know, certain companies have come out with something which we all, you know, really like, we've already got a great platform underneath that we can start exploring other areas. Like, you know, there's an area of dementia or autism or dyslexia. All these areas can be potentially facilitated by wearable displays that kind of in some way manipulate and tune your outside environment.